you for joining us today. We trust that you will be motivated, challenged, and inspired by this week's message. Let's join Mike now.
That this cell adhesion protein molecule actually looks like this. I still look at that, and I don't know about you, but it just, wow, I just go, that's so cool. Do you see the parallels of laminin and the cross? We wouldn't know what to do or who to be without the cross to hold on to. We wouldn't know up or down, left or right, forwards or backwards without the cross. In fact, we literally die. The cross is our glue holding us together. We just think, well, God is holding us in his hand, but he's not just holding us in his hand. He's holding us together inside in shape of a cross. Your life is so precious to God, so incredibly precious that he personally watched over its creation. Your life was planned in heaven long before it was ever seen on earth. Let's not waste that opportunity of having that great relationship with God, because he went to a lot of trouble to make sure that he was not seen as this distant superpower that could put the planets in the sky. But hey, what could he do for people? What he did for us far exceeds what he's ever done in the universe. Doesn't matter how low I go or how far I drift or how distant I become, God is always there, because God can't leave you. He goes with you. Verse 4 says, you know what I'm going to say even before I say it. Oh, that's scary. Now some of you are nervous. He knows what's going to come out of this before we exercise all 70 muscles to speak. Before we even generate the thoughts to formulate the words, he already knows what's going to proceed out of our mouth. Here's the one I really... This for me is, this is it. Verse 5, you go before me and follow me. Before me, follow me. How does that work? So he's our leader and our follower. He's ahead of us, behind us, and with us. Get your head around that. So he's ahead of us, so we're not out there on our own. He's with us, so as we're walking, we're not alone. And he's behind us, backing us all the way. Why? Because he is everywhere. Behind, with us, and ahead of us. There is nowhere that you're going to go that God goes, wow, why did you go there? I didn't even know there existed. He goes, I know how far you're going to travel sometimes, and it's going to be there. I'm already there. How many of you ever kind of gone ahead of God, or you thought you had? Like you did something that you shouldn't have done. Anybody ever made a financial decision? I'm sure I'm going to see a lot of hands if you were really honest, that you really shouldn't have made, but you bought something you shouldn't have bought, you did something you shouldn't have done. It's kind of like, oh man. But somehow God was already there. Like, we shouldn't even have survived, but somehow we did, even making that mistake. God goes, you know what? I know it was bad, but it wasn't so bad that it was out of the realm of what I can do. That's what's so awesome about God. But you see, we want to treat people like, well, suffer. You made that mistake, you need to suffer. That's because we've grown up, perhaps, with that kind of culture. Well, you know, you pay the price, son. I can hear it. I probably didn't ever get told that, but somehow in my upbringing, someone said it to someone, and I've applied it to my life. Well, you made a mistake. Now you have to reap the consequences. Well, that is true. There are consequences to our decisions, but here's the thing. God's already there, even in the mistake. Are you getting this picture of how much God cares? I mean, there is nothing you can do to come out of his love. He's in us, he's with us, he's over us, he's everywhere. And that just blows our mind full stop. We can't even get our head. You mean he's here Yeah. Do you mean he's down the road in the other church? Yeah. Do you mean he's outside? Yes, he is. What did Lewis say this week? To Sadie, I love the fact that Sadie's having to really stay on her toes with the kids because they're asking all the difficult questions. So, hang on, Sadie. If God is there, if I punch right now, does that mean I'm punching God? Answer that one, Sadie. She's like, well, I guess so because God is there. That probably doesn't hurt him. God is everywhere. God is here. Such knowledge, he says, is too wonderful for me, too great for me to understand. Well, you're right there. Whew. Can't get my head around this stuff. Been a pastor for 20-odd years now. Been in church leadership for 25 years. Still can't get my head around it. In fact, the older I grow, the more gobsmacked I am. Isn't that the way we're supposed to be? That as this amazing love and this amazing God who unfolds this amazing love and this plan and purpose in our lives, it should just keep getting better because our best days are ahead of us. So every day we should be going, wow, I didn't get you yesterday. I still don't get you today because you've done something more now. I mean, I thought I was going to run out, Lord, of the grace that you extend towards me. I thought I was going to go beyond. I mean, I thought I was going to commit the worst sin in the world, and that would definitely be out of your realm of grace. Nothing is outside of that realm of grace. He says it right here. I can never escape from your spirit. I can never get away from your presence. Do you realize that no one is ever too far away from God without an opportunity to get back? We just have to make the decision while we have the opportunity. Why do you often hear preachers going, come on, just make the decision today? Why? Because you might not be here tomorrow to make the decision. Let's make it while today is still called today. Let's not leave life to chance. Let's not get right with God or leave it till it's too late. Remember, I told you last week that I shared with my dad on his deathbed that I loved him. If I'd have left it to another day, I wouldn't have had that opportunity. Sometimes we can live life with regret that we didn't do something. Let's not live that way any longer. Let's make the most of the opportunity that's ahead of us, that we have right now to be able to say, God, do you know what? I might not have been everything that I needed to be, but today I want to take this opportunity to draw close to you. Do you know what he's basically getting at here? What it means is if we have loved ones that seem a million miles away from God right now, the reality is they're actually very close. Because God is never far away. Do you know what it is? The separation is not distance. We can only really kind of think about things with the mind that we have. God doesn't think the way we think. So we think, well, you know, so-and-so's like a million miles away from God right now. No, because God is actually as close as he can ever be. So they can't be a million miles away. Do you know what the separation is? It's not distance, it's insight. It's a realization, it's a change of perspective, and that person can come that quickly to know God. God is right with us, even when and if we're not right with him. He is right here, right now. That's why there's hope for our loved ones. God looks at my family, my brother, my sister, the ones that have never given their lives to the Lord, my brother-in-law that I've often kind of thought, wow, God, you're going to have to really work. But you know what? They are that close. They are as close as I ever was. And the only difference is I made a decision to say yes for God. And that's the only thing that they need to do. There is no distance. It's just understanding. It's just acceptance. Psalmist said, if I go up to heaven, you are there. If I go down to the grave, you're there. If I ride on the wings in the morning, if I dwell by the farthest oceans, even there your hand will guide me and your strength will support me. I just want to say this, wherever, whenever, whatever, however, it doesn't matter where we are, God is there. He will guide us. He will support us. He will hold us together. I could ask, he says, the darkness to hide me and the light around me to become night, but even in the darkness, I cannot hide from you. Even when we go through our darkest times, it says to you, God, the night shines as bright as the day, and darkness and light are the same. He doesn't see the things and he doesn't experience the things that we experience. I put in my notes here, OMG, you can run, but you can't hide. You run from God, but you can't hide from him. And he goes on about all the delicate inner parts of our body. I think we have an understanding of that, having looked at that the last couple of weeks. You know, there's nothing you can teach God. There's nothing you can tell him. He knows it all. The psalmist ends by saying, thank you for making me so wonderfully complex. Your workmanship is marvelous. How well I know it. You watched me as I was being formed in utter seclusion, as I was woven together in the dark of the womb. You saw me before I was born. Every day of my life was recorded in your book. Every moment was laid out before a single day had passed. I love reading that. Do you realize no one can muck up your life? Oh, I've had so many people try and sabotage my life. I think some of them on purpose. You know, sometimes the people that come against you are so jealous of what you have. And you look at yourself and you go, why would they be jealous of me? I mean, you know, I'm just a normal person. I don't have a lot. No, you see, it's not about material stuff that they're necessarily jealous about. They're jealous about the peace and the joy and the fulfillment that you have in your life, because those things are priceless. When they're struggling, but then when you're struggling, two different things. And they wish that they had what you've got, not realizing that it's that close. But you know, no one can stop. Remember that thing that they talk about at weddings? What God has joined together, let no man separate. What God has planned for you, let no man mess with. Because he can, try. Oh, you can kind of go, oh, if you just not done that, it's all right, God will find another way. God's always got another way. I mean, come on, if we'd have fallen for some of the tricks that the enemy's tried with our church, we wouldn't even be standing here today. People doing stuff. Sometimes you see people working on the wrong side. It's like, why are you doing that? You're supposed to be a Christian. Why would you? Because people are human beings and the enemy uses people. Do you know, as I was reading that, every moment laid out, everything set according to his plan, everything planned according to his purpose, every minute of our life is already planned. Do you know what? All we've got to do is fall into that plan. Accept that plan. Most of the time we are fighting the plan. Accept who you are in God. Don't keep looking for what you're not, but thank God for what you are. He ends by saying this, how precious are your thoughts about me? It's personal. Listen to this and just apply this to yourself right now. How precious are your thoughts about me? They cannot even be numbered. They actually outnumber the grains of sand. I can't count them. And when I wake up, you're still with me. Do you wake up some mornings, you go, wow, God, you're still with me. Wow, I'm still breathing. Some of the times you thought that was going to be your last night. Some of those times when you've walked through the valley of the shadow of death, literally. You didn't think you were going to make it through another night. You didn't think you were going to. How many of you sometimes go to bed so stressed you can't sleep? there's this worry and that worry and the other worry on you, and you just think, I'm not going to survive tomorrow. I can't cope anymore. Somehow you wake up, God is with you, gives you fresh perspective that following day, and somehow you can take on the world again. We shouldn't be surprised, because he's holding us together. And it says that the thoughts he has about you cannot even be numbered. Can you imagine? So the thoughts outnumber the grains of sand on the seashore. So don't just think about Western Supermare Beach. Like every bit of sand you've ever, well, not even just the bits you've seen, but every bit of sand that exists. And I've not been to Dubai, somewhere I'd like to go, but there's a lot of sand there. Every thought, you can't even start to number. And that's just you. How many thoughts is God having about 7 billion people right now? And you know, here's the thing. Not one of them is a bad thought. Every single thought he's got about you is a good one. Well, Pastor, you don't know what I've done this week. Don't make any difference. You could do your worst and he's still thinking his best about you. We sang it this morning. He always sees the best in us. I think my wife was so anointed the day that she got to write the lyrics of that song. Really touches me still. He sees the best in us, not the worst. I had so much more to say, and don't have any time to say it. And now I've got to skim over this, because I can't do another part next week. I've just got to say, we're encouraged to give our worries and our cares to God. I do have to say this. I can't skip this. Luke 12 verse 6. You see, when we begin to understand how much he cares for us, we'll understand just how much he values us. Do you realize you are valuable to God? He values you greatly. He says, what is the price of 5 sparrows? If you live where we live, we see a lot of sparrows and birds and stuff. 2 copper coins. Yet God does not forget a single one of them. Do you realize that there's not one of those sparrows? There's a scripture that says his eye is on the sparrow. How many sparrows must there be in the world? Too many. And yet not one of them goes without his notice. And you go, well, what's the point of looking at the sparrows? Because he created them. Because they're important to him. And it says, and the very hairs on your head are all numbered. Like Dave said this morning, he's done God a favor because God doesn't have to count his anymore. He said it, not me. All the very hairs on your head are all numbered. So don't be afraid. You are more valuable to God than a whole flock of sparrows. Can you, hang on. We've got 100,000 to 150,000 hairs on our head. Just check that they're still there. Yeah, mine just about still there. And he has numbered every single one of them. And he knows when they're not there. So this week when number 800 fell out, he knew. And number 1,501 went gray. He knew all about it. He wasn't as shocked as you were when you looked in the mirror and went, ah, gray hair. I don't have time to read it, but read Luke 12 when you get home. It talks about everyday life and how we worry about things that we really don't need to worry about. Having enough food, having enough clothes. What we're going to eat, what we're going to wear. Doesn't life become so preoccupied with stuff sometimes? And then sometimes you just go to bed at night and you just start to think a little bit beyond just that kind of stuff. And you go, do you know what? I don't know why I'm stressed about this. It will be as it's going to be. And God will provide, and that's exactly what it's saying. Listen, God provides. For even the flowers, it says, you know, look at the lilies and how they grow. but they don't work or make their clothing. Yet Solomon, in all his glory, was not dressed as beautifully as they are. And if God cares so wonderfully for the flowers, how many of you gardeners? Don't know where Gemma got gardening from, but she loved gardening. Oh, well, Lois kind of likes gardening, but I cannot stand gardening. But she is a gardener. So she'd talk about flowers. So she knows what I'm talking about today. When you look at the flowers, you're like, how did that grow? How did that get to look so beautiful? We got some lilies right now. And they are amazing. It says if God cares so wonderfully for them, that here today and gone tomorrow, you know, flowers last, depending on temperature in your house, not very long in ours. So you bin them, you think, well, they looked so nice when we first had them, but they don't last a long time. And he says, if God cares that much to make flowers that beautiful, don't you think that he cares so much more for you and will make sure that your needs are met? I don't know what more we could say and what more God could say, because I think he said it all. And I don't know whether you're going to go out feeling encouraged today, feeling like you're the most important person in the world, because you are. Forget about the celebrities and the VIPs and the ranking order of the world. Oh, I wish I was like so-and-so. No, you don't. Do you know what? They're not as happy as they make out. I was talking to someone here a couple of weeks ago, and we were talking about people, millionaires and multimillionaires, and you're saying, you know, not one of them's happy. I said, you know what? They won't be, because they're after the next bit of money, thinking that the next bit of money is going to make them happy, and they get the next bit of money, and it doesn't make them happy. Oh, I'm not saying we couldn't all do with a bit more money. It's not going to make you happy, though. Well, if only I had another pair of shoes, now I'm talking your language, girls, I would be happy. You ever bought that other pair of shoes and you were happy for about 5 minutes, then you're on to the next pair of shoes? What is it about shoes, handbags, and women? Something that God built in there. And actually, most of the time, the excitement was the build-up. Believing for it, the expectation, oh, I so want those shoes. And then when you got them, just a pair of shoes. Oh, now I've got a scratch on them. Oh. Really what Jesus was trying to get us to focus on was, listen, your life is far more important than food and clothing and everyday stuff. So don't worry about that. I'll provide for that. Let's focus on the bigger things. Let's focus on the things that really matter in life. Let's focus on the one who made us. That's holding us literally together.
We hope you have enjoyed today's message. To download further resources, click on the resources icon. If this message has impacted your life, we would love to hear from you. So don't forget to join us next week for another inspiring message.